Hello everybody. This map you see here was made in less than 20 minutes using only the things taught in this tutorial. Have fun. Previously on this tutorial series. So far we have a working level, but there are problems with the lighting. Some things are completely black, whilst other things are bright. To fix this you need to add lighting. Here it is before lighting, and here it is after. I'm sure you'll agree that it's a big improvement. So let's get on with it. You make a light the same way that you make a person. You go up to the entity tool, select it, click somewhere in the level, go up to the selection tool, select it, and double click on the entity you just made. However, instead of choosing a player in the drop down list, type light. Once selected, click apply. Well done, you now have a working light in your level. I'm going to move it to the middle of the level to get the best lighting. It doesn't tend to work too well if the light's in a wall. This should now work in game. As you can see, this is a very important part of the tutorial. Make sure you have annotations turned on for this video and click on the part you wish to watch. Or you can watch through all of it. Click on the Block tool on the left-hand side of the screen. Click Browse and find the texture you wish to use. Double-click on it, then drag out a square in one of the grid views. Once you're happy with its position, press Enter to make it. If you want to change the size of one you've already made, click on the Selection tool and select the block you wish to edit. You can then drag the edges in all directions. You can use the scroll mouse to zoom in on this grid view. If you're finding the grid the wrong size for the blocks you're trying to make, change the size of the grid. You can do this by clicking on the plus and minus buttons here. As you can see, I can now choose more precise sizes. When it comes to texturing something you've already made, you can either texture all of it or one face of it. To texture all of it, click on the selection tool and click on the object you wish to retexture. Click on the Browse button at the right-hand side of the screen and choose a texture. Now click on the Apply Current Texture button on the left-hand side of the screen and it should change to the new texture. If you want to texture individual faces, you can use a very powerful tool called the Toggle Texture Application tool. Once you've clicked here, you'll get this little menu. When you click Apply, any of the faces that are selected will change to the new texture. Alternatively, you can choose a texture and then right-click on a face to change it. So once again, you click Browse, find the texture you want to use, and then right-click on the faces to change them to the new texture. If you want to have sky in your level, it works the same way as a normal texture. Click Browse and find the skybox texture. It helps to type skybox in the filter box at the bottom. Find the texture that looks like this, double-click on it, and apply it to any wall that you want to look like sky in the game. The first tool I'm going to talk about is the clipping tool. It lets you cut objects in half. Click on the selection tool at the top of the screen and select the block you wish to cut in half. Now click on the clipping tool. To use it, move the mouse over one of the grid views and hold down the mouse button to make the cut. The area that's in white will be left after you press the enter button. If you make a cut but don't press enter, you can click on the clipping tool and it will choose which area is left after you press enter. If both sides are white, as you can see here, it will create two separate objects. Now on to the second tool. The vertex tool lets you adjust the edges of objects you have already made. First of all, make sure the object is selected. Now click on the vertex tool and you'll find lots of white squares around the outside of the object. Select one of these and drag the mouse to adjust the position of the corner. Once you're happy, click on the selection tool to save the new shape of the object. There are some advanced shapes that you can use in the editor. To get to them, click on the block tool on the left-hand side of the screen, then on the right-hand side of the screen, find this drop-down list. I won't go into them in detail now, but some of them are more useful than others. Have a go. Just be sure to set it back to block after you've finished. Objects include trees, barrels, bottles on the floor, cars, things like that. To add one to the level, click on the Entity tool and click somewhere in the level. Now go up to the selection tool and double click on the entity you just made. Type prop and several options will appear. The only ones you need will be prop dynamic, prop physics, and prop static. I'm going to use prop static as it works for most objects. Click apply, then click on world model. Click browse, and if you have a problem with this screen loading up, quit it and click browse again. Once it's loaded, type the name of the object you wish to add in the filter box. I'm going to choose a tree. You can click on the info tab and it will show you all the types of objects it will work for. This is useful if it doesn't show up in game or if there's an error. I use prop static for things that don't move and prop physics for things that do move. Not all things work with prop physics. For example, this tree doesn't. Click OK and then click apply for it to appear in the level.